Okay, this video is for everyone in Math 50C and Math 50D, all the students that I coach in those classes at El Camino College, and anyone else out there in YouTube land that wants to understand the order of operations. So we're going to take a look at this problem here, 32 divided by 2 times 5 minus 1 plus 3. And we're going to start by writing the order of operations over here on the left-hand side, parentheses, exponents. That little 2 up there is an exponent. Multiplication, division, addition, subtraction, right? And you want to follow this order of operations. So the first thing we see here when we look at this problem is we want to check off and see, are there parentheses? Because that's the first on the list here. So we go, okay, parentheses. Yeah, there's a parentheses right there. So that's where we start, right there. So we have, first off, 5 minus 1 within the parentheses. So we're going to say, okay, everything else we leave the same, 32 divided by 2, and then inside we've got 5 minus 1, so we're going to put a little V here to indicate that what we've done is we've changed that 5 minus 1 to a 4 squared plus 3, right? That's our first step. Now, there still is a parentheses here, but there's nothing inside the parentheses for us to do. There's a 4. There's no addition, multiplication, division, subtraction. That's all we can do with that parentheses at this point, okay? We can't simplify that anymore. So we're going to cross off the parentheses here. Check that off. We've done that, right? And so what do we have next here? Oh, exponents. Are there any exponents? Yes, there are exponents. So we're going to, next thing we're going to take this 4 squared, because that's saying 4. That's saying square what's inside the parentheses, so that's going to be 4 times 4, which is now 16, and then plus 3, and times 2, and we could just put a little dot there. We could leave the parentheses if we want, or put a dot that signifies multiplication. 32 divided by 2. Okay? So we're going to put the little V here, so we know that when we go back and look at this problem later, if we make a mistake, that we could say, oh look, we changed this 4 squared to a 16. So we've done our exponents. We check that off. Now, what's next on the list? Oh, look, multiplication and slash division. Oh, wait a minute, there's division and there's multiplication. Which one do we, how do we decide which one goes first? Well, notice there's this slash D here, M slash D. That means you work left to right. Sometimes multiplication goes first, sometimes division goes first. If division shows up first on the left, as it does in this case, that means you do division first. If instead it, multiplication showed up on the left, then you do multiplication first. So since division does shows up first left to right, that means that's what we're going to do right now. So we're going to take 32 divided by 2 and we get 16 times 16 plus 3, right? Okay, so now we're going to again put our V here, so we know that we took this V. And we know that we did 32 divided by 2 to get 16. Now, what do we have left? So we check off division is done, right? Put a little check next to division. Oh, are there any oh, there's still multiplication, though. Multiplication comes before addition, which is the last thing we have on there. So we're going to go 16 times 16. And what do we get? 6, 96, 0, 6, 1, 6. And we have 9 and 5, 9 and 6 is 15, carry 1, and we have 256. So now we have 256, and we're going to do our upside down V as well. So let's make this a little bit more clear here. So there's our upside down V, and we have 256 plus 3. So multiplication is now checked off. And the last thing on our list there is addition. So we go 256 plus 3, and we have 259. All right, so take a look at that, review it. You know, if you have any questions, scroll back. This is YouTube. You can always scroll back. And I'll see you in class.